Tonight on 308 Seconds, Mayor Johnny McGee talks about his Irish heritage and the possibility of war with Ellisville.
I'm Jim Sigelski. These stories and more tonight on 308 Seconds.
Mayor McGee, which do you prefer to be called? Your Excellency, Your Royal Highness, or Your Most Exalted Grand Eminence?
Well, I like Excellency pretty good because that's what I strive for. So I think Your Excellency will be the best.
Okay. Your Excellency, we might as well start by bringing up the elephant in the room. You and I have had a well-documented public feud resulting from my in-depth reporting that exposed the fact that when you took the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge, there seemed to be a severe drought going on in the Gatorade bucket that was poured over your head by the Laurel Tornado football team. How do you respond?
I respond that the ice was cold.
Okay. All right. But was there really a fair amount of water in that bucket?
Well, I think it was, because after it was over, I took my suit to riser cleaners, and they said that it was so wet that it may not could be saved.
Okay. I say we go ahead and bury the hatchet and move beyond it.
We can do that today.
Okay, good. Were you born and raised in Laurel?
My birth certificate says that I was born and raised in Laurel.
Okay. You weren't possibly raised in another country, were you?
Well, now, I'm not sure about the early years. I don't remember too much until around the sixth grade.
Okay. Do you get a lot of crazies calling you up?
Every day.
Every day. I kind of assumed you did, because we get a lot of crazies coming in the paper, and I imagine it's tenfold when you're the mayor.
Yes, exactly.
What's the craziest call you've received as the mayor?
Probably one about, actually it was a visit. A fella had his lights turned off, and he came by and he wanted the city to issue a edict against Mississippi Power to keep them from turning people's power off that had late bills.
Okay, all right. Did you make that edict?
I eased him out the door.
Eased him out the door. Yeah. Have you ever thought about declaring war on Ellisville?
It has come up a couple times, but every time it came up, Mayor Waldrop and I have sat down and worked it out. And, you know, right now we are at an armistice, but any day now, if he tries to encroach any closer to Laurel, it probably will lead to war.
If he amassed armed forces on the Laurel-Ellisville border, how would you respond?
Well, I believe that we have a very capable police force. We also have several employees who are National Guard, so I would attempt to circumvent the law and to nationalize our National Guard so that they could protect our city. I know he will probably try to use the sheriff to help him because he is
right
in Jones County.
Yep.
But I would probably try to get the Attorney General to rule that the sheriff could not be used inside two municipalities fighting.
Who do you think Hattiesburg would side with in that little dispute?
It's kind of hard because Ellisville is closer. They may try to help
Ellisville. Okay. Yeah. Well, all right. Well, maybe we could rely on Waynesboro or somebody.
Well, hopefully we could.
All right. Have you ever been in your office late at night and heard the ghost of Melvin Mack?
I hear the ghost of Melvin Mack at least once a day.
Once a day. I'm going to give you some rapid-fire choices, and I want you to just quickly pick your preference. Oatmeal or cream of wheat?
Oatmeal.
Saltines or Wheat Thins?
Wheat Thins.
Tony Thaxton or Tony Wheat?
Tony Thaxton.
Cheerios or Wheaties?
Wheaties.
Good Times or the Jeffersons?
Good Times.
Black Bear or Colonel Reb?
Colonel Reb.
Taylor Swift or Kanye West?
Neither.
Ice hockey or bowling?
Bowling.
McGee, it's obviously an Irish name. Have you ever visited your ancestral home?
Not as of today, I have not.
You have not?
Have not.
Have not, okay.
I intend to.
You do intend to?
Yes, and I want to find out what village I was in Ireland and meet some of the relatives.
How much would it cost for me to get one of those keys to the city?
It's according to which doors you want it to open.
Okay, and I was actually going to ask you what that key actually opens.
It actually opens absolutely nothing.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Okay, so it's really not worth all that much.
It's not worth the metal it's made out of.
Okay, and I'm glad we could put our feud behind us.
I'm also glad, and I hope that if war comes with Ellisville that you'll be ready to suit up and
I will be ready to pick up arms.